In a previous video, we looked at the chorus, flanger, and phaser devices, which use a free-running modulation to drive their effects. No matter how you change the settings though, the shape of that modulation is always a sine wave. Let's see if we can do something about that. The three effects share a common feature, the reset button. This is a powerful method of controlling the modulation, especially when changing the position of the reset with effect commands. The modulation still remains a sine wave, but that option of position changing is also available for control via meta devices, because the reset is actually a valid destination. You can certainly create some interesting results from the formula and signal follower, but to get some solid examples quickly and easily, let's try out the LFO. Because it's kind of a hack against what these effects are naturally doing, there's a couple of important points to remember when using this technique. First, the effect's sine wave modulation is still always running, which will fight with the repositioning by continually moving away from it. The higher the rate, the more obvious this will be. Second, you're not actually replacing the original shape with the chosen shape, meaning that the output value, as shown by the meter here, does not usually match the value here. It's easy to forget, but the values being sent are the positions on the sine wave that you want to reset to. For this reason, when using the LFO, it's easier to understand what's going on with the default amplitude and offset values of 50%. So, the other device featuring a reset button is the LFO, which you can also select as a destination. Since the LFO isn't restricted to a sine wave, you may be wondering, what's the point? Well, when connecting devices together, like this, you're exploring the open-ended modularity of effects in Renoise and Redux, generating unpredictable, but perhaps creatively useful results. Another factor is that in custom shape mode, there is the one-shot toggle. A specific example of how this can be useful with reset control is shown in another video, Variable Trigger Values Effects. So check that out to learn about introducing variety on a per-note basis.